So I'd like to welcome everyone here this evening to Holographic Sound Healing and what is it, Healing and Meditation Experience. I need a script so I can remember what I wrote, you know. We do this hopefully one Monday a month, and I try and keep it on the first or second Mondays. And depending, it typically depends on whether, you know, whether I'm traveling or not. So here we are, second Monday. And again, welcome those of you that are here, those of you that are online with us. And again, an amazing time. You know, it's like so many things are going on, so many things are happening now. We do the evening on a love donation basis, and there's a basket that'll go around at the end if you haven't already taken care of that. And if you don't feel like you wanna, like I said, it's a love donation, so either do it or you don't, whatever you feel right about. So anyhow, this time in our evolution, you know, in our life experience, there's so many things going on. I mean, it's like, you know, astrologically, there's all kinds of, I have to watch my words, you know, there's all kinds of stuff happening, you know. And it's affecting us there's a lot of solar flares and things that have been going on that have been infusing our energy. And if anybody has experienced some ups and downs, which, I don't know, anybody, or is it just me? This is why. It's not necessarily that there's anything wrong. It's just a lot of energy happening. You know, and for us, it's just up to rolling with the energy, to roll with the experience and not get taken in by it, but taking it in, you know. So anyhow, for me, things that are occurring with holographic sound, this is February, March, about half of March, I'll be gone. I think I'll be able to be here. I think we've scheduled, what are we scheduled? The first Monday in March? Okay. So first Monday in March, we'll be here for the meditation. Beyond that, I'll be in Denver for a few weeks doing an expo and then a holographic sound healing certification training. And then back from that in the middle of April, I'll be going to South Africa to do two trainings there, one in Johannesburg and one in Cape Town, which I'm really looking forward to because I've never been there before. So I think that's going to be an extraordinary experience. At least it is for me. I don't know if anybody else will, you know, it'll be extraordinary for them, but it's going to be extraordinary for me. And then on, and there's other things. You can find all the stuff that's going on at holographicsound.com on the website. And if you want to sign up, if you're not on the newsletter list, you can sign up before you go and get on there. And we'll let you know what's happening because there's a lot of stuff happening, a lot of trainings going on and other events of that sort. And the next big one coming up is in October, and that'll be the next journey to Egypt. I've been taking groups to Egypt for going on 25 years now, and they're extraordinary experiences. It's like every time I go, it's just another, you know, another, what's the word, you know, just another uplifting of energy and feeling that I get. So, and they're extraordinary. This one is two full weeks, 14 days, 4-day, 4-night cruise on the Nile, private visit in the King's Chamber and in the pyramid where we'll do a sound ceremony on Halloween night, literally 1 a.m. in the morning. So we'll be in the Great Pyramid right at Halloween night, breaking into the Dawn of the Dead, or the Day of the Dead. And it sounds so much better if you say it in Spanish. So somebody please help me here, if you speak Spanish, and say
Día de los Muertos.
What,
Día
what?
De los Muertos.
Okay. It sounds so much better.
Yes. You know?
But anyway, and what that is energetically is the veils are so much thinner at that time. It's not like, you know, any weird stuff is going to happen. It's just that the veils are so thin and we're so able to connect with the divine beings, the higher beings, the masters that work with us all the time, whether we know it or not. And so anyhow, we'll be inside the pyramid, which is such a portal of energy just all by itself, much less the day that it's occurring and everything. So anyhow, we leave on October 19th and return on December 2nd. So if you're drawn, I know some of you that are in here have been and experienced it. And if you're drawn, just check it out. Check it out. I've got flyers in the front. Put them on your refrigerator, and so you can see it and set your intentions and make it happen if you choose. So anyway, with everything happening now, we've just moved through the brink of a new moon, and this is the new moon in the sun sign of Aquarius. And the new moon is a perfect time, always. There's always, all time is a perfect time. But the new moon in particular is a perfect time to set your intentions. So if you haven't had a chance to write down your intentions and put them in the bowl up here, then if you want to do that, then do it. If you want to just hold that intention for yourself and consciousness, that's fine as well. So just be sure and set an intention for yourself, for this evening, for this experience. And it can be simply for this evening, it can be for this month, it can be for this year, it can be whatever you want it to be. So, but by all means, set the intention, because that gives the sound a clear place to go, because the sound will follow the intention. Whatever intentions you're setting, the sound will follow that. So, what else? Any questions? No, that was for me. I'm asking myself if there were any questions. No, I'm kidding. I was really asking you. But myself as well. And no, I don't have any questions. So, let's just get on with it. Wouldn't you do that when you hit the lights? Oh, one last thing. After 20 years, I have finally almost completed my first book. And it will be out. It'll be a couple of months before I'll be able to release it. But I've got other writings that have been published, but this is the first real book. And so I'm really thrilled with that. And I'll be sure and let you know when it's all here and everything. So anyhow.
I have a question.
Yes.
What's the book about?
I'll tell you the title. The title is The Healing Power of Holographic Sound. And I have a subtitle to it, but I can't remember it.
You better write this book quick.
It's there.
We're all losing it.
So, and I won't go into that anymore, but the power of sound, and particularly the power of holographic sound, it'll float your boat, I'm telling you. So I've got one extra bowl up here tonight, and it's causing me to reconfigure things, which is cool. I figured since this is like we're 2 days before, what is that day? Valentine's Day? The day of love?
San Valentín.
What was that?
San Valentín.
Is it, that's in Spanish? Okay. Thanks for that, because I never would have gotten it. And so one of the focuses tonight is connecting with that vibration of love. And it's not just romantic love. It's like just unconditional, pure love, the purest love vibration. And that's like, you know, in the Constitution, it says goodwill to all men kind of thing, you know, something like that. Well, that's the thing, men and women, you know, mankind, personkind. So just keep that focus as well, you know, that this is just to open your heart and to really embrace the vibration of love. Love to one another. Love to those that we don't like. Those that cross us. Those that do things that way go against what we believe and what we feel. But yet, we are all one, you know? And even though someone does something that's vastly different than what you might do, or something that you just don't condone, we're still one with that being. You know, we are all essences and energies of love, essences and energies of the divine. So there. I'm done. So let's go home now. I invite you to close your eyes. Just begin to focus on your breathing. And as you do, just visualize or imagine the beautiful sphere of light around our group, around the room, and this sphere of light including Source, below to the heart center of Mother Earth. intending that all transformation is only that that is in your highest good. Only that. As you breathe. Turn to look behind you. its pink and its color as its rose quartz. You can feel the essence, the energy, the vibration of love that emanates from it. And as you begin to make your way to the pyramid, beginning up the steps, noticing the steps are obsidian, as this black obsidian wall beam it does. You will notice every cell in your body illuminated in joy, in love, in more love, in goodness, in happiness. With every breath that you breathe in, as this essence, this energy, this vibration moves through the beauty. as you breathe, knowing with every breath, you breathe in the life force, every cell illuminated in harmony, in wholeness, in balance. The intentions set have been met right here, right now. Is there anything that anyone would like to share of your experience? Or any questions, comments? Anything at all? Actually, before we do this, let's say goodbye to those who are streaming with us. Much love to you. Thank you for the blessings, for the vibration that you bring to this experience, all of us, because the energies, the vibration, the tones that come through, they're all about you. And they're specific and perfect for whatever energies and whatever intentions that you have set. I don't know what they're going to be until they come out. So thank you for doing your part and bringing your essence and your vibration to this experience. So, and to everybody streaming, much love and blessings. I hope to see you next month on the first Monday.